السلام عليكم.
They enjoyed reading the Quran, and when they read the Quran, it increased them in faith. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Sahaba were traveling, returning on from the battle, or going towards the battle, on the way to the battle or to, from the battle, and they decided to take camp. And when they settled down, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked the companions, "Who will guard us for the night?" Two companions, they said, "O Messenger of Allah, we will take the responsibility of the ribat, of guarding the army during the night." Everyone settled down, they went to sleep. One Sahabi said to the other that rather than us wasting this night, tomorrow we have a long journey ahead of us, why don't you sleep half the night and I'll sleep the other half? They agreed to this. One Sahabi lied down, he went to sleep. The Sahabi that was guarding, he was looking around, he couldn't see anyone coming his way. He thought, you know what, rather than wasting these moments, why don't I pray Salah? We'd pull out our phones and start playing our games. And he started his Salah. And while he's praying Salah, the enemy come and they see everyone sleeping except for this one man that's standing. And they take an arrow and they fire it at him. And the arrow hits him. And he doesn't stop his Salah, he's continuing his Salah and he's praying. And they take another arrow and they fire it at him and it hits him again and he continues his prayer. And let me put context to this. Each arrow is like a bullet. Imagine being shot with a bullet in your arm and you don't even cinch. You just stand right there and you're praying your Salah. And they continued firing at him and he was flowing with blood. And the Shafi'i scholars, they use this hadith as a proof that the flowing of blood from the body does not break the wudu. Because the Sahabi continued his prayer. And he says, the only reason why I broke my prayer was because I feared that had they continued to fire arrows at me, I would have died. And if I died, then the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was at danger. So then I broke my prayer. And the Sahaba, they asked him that, what were you doing? How did you not feel the pain of the arrows? He said, how could I feel the pain of the arrows when I was reciting the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?